Hi folks, welcome to another episode of the Reba Aya Show. On our show today, we have someone who's very special and who's very unique. He happens to be an IPS officer and is a lover of poetry. Kaisar Saab, welcome to the show.
Thank you, sir.
A beautiful, wonderful, rare combination of poetry with administration. How do you amalgamate it?
It's not very difficult. A lot of people ask me this question. But let me tell you, for poetry, you need to have a sensitive heart and a reflecting mind.
Okay.
And in an administration like police, you get to see so many different situations of human relations. Every case that comes before us or every application which people bring to us,
correct,
is a story of some kind of relationship not working, something faulty, something going berserk, or something which is not as per the what we express a normal course of things.
Correct.
Now when you look at that thing, at the surface of it, it is a complaint.
Yes.
Or it is some story. But when you start prodding, why did this happen? How did this happen? What was it that led to this situation? You will come to a web of relationships, a lot of things which are actually between humans. And my firm conviction is this, that the whole literature that we read is the story of human relationships. We have the biggest relationship that we have is with we ourselves. Me as a person, me as a human being, me as a self, and me as a member of the society, me as a member of the family, me as a member of the country, and internationally as a human being, a member of human race, and my own relationship with these things as well as my environment where I exist. It gives you a lot of messages, a lot of stories, a lot of raw material for stories. And from there, suppose I often give this example, there's a marine drive here.
Correct.
Right across.
Correct.
A kilometer or two from here. If you take a walk in the evening, you will find thousands of people.
Yes.
In different stages of relationship.
Yes.
There will be some pairs, there will be some lovers, there will be some families, there will be some people who will be just roaming, there will be some people who will be sailing. A lot of people in different kind of emotional states and different kinds of connectedness.
Correct.
So what happens? I look, I observe, and I see what's going on.
Right.
A lot of people discussing different things, some politics, some films, some intimate things. So it gives you the food for thought. Similarly, when people come here, when they speak, it gives a lot of food for thought. So what happens when I'm alone or when I'm a little free? I would reflect on that.
Kaisar Saab, now you are in such a big position, you're an IPS officer. Now the perspective of the world. Bazi chahe atfal hai duniya mere aage, hota hai shab o roz tamasha mere aage.
Bilkul.
How do you see the world through this shair?
Very aptly told this shair of
Thank you.
Bazi chahe atfal hai duniya mere aage, hota hai shab o roz tamasha mere aage. In fact, this is true for police department because all the time we keep getting complaints.
Exactly.
And due to this, sometimes we lose empathy. Even though I know why this has happened, I must empathize with the person with whom this mishap has happened. Because half of his battle is won if I speak to him with empathy, speak to him with courtesy, with a lot of love and compassion, and don't blame him for that. What has happened?
Okay.
The problem is this, that in our system, we start blaming the victim. Why had you gone there? It's a very simple question. Why were you at that point of time, at that place? None of our business to ask somebody in a free country, in a democratic country, why did somebody went somewhere?
Exactly.
What time did somebody go there? What somebody did so long as it is legal? If it is illegal, fine. It is the problem with the other party who has done some wrongful loss to this, caused some wrongful loss to this person. So we must always think of that we are not here to impose some moral boundaries on population. We are here to empathize with their cause and assure them that we will look into their complaints. We will see to it that it is investigated and the culprit is brought to justice. And also to solve whatever other problems this person had in the course of that thing. He might have been injured, he might have suffered something, that kind of thing. So I think even though when you know why this has happened, it is very important to keep our humanism intact and to speak to people with courtesy, with a lot of love, compassion, and make that person feel comfortable and welcome in your setting.
Exactly. It's slightly the other way around. People are scared of interacting with the police. My own personal observation when I see the cops around. A cop who has a star, starting from number one star, who's a senior SI or that. That cop is mannered, he's cultured, and he knows that what to talk, when to talk, how to talk. But those officials or those police cops who haven't achieved the star as yet, they are a bit rough and raw in their language. Do you agree with this?
Unfortunately, the circumstances in which we operate are not very good.
Okay.
I'm talking nationally across the country. I remember if you go to Bihar, for example, that was my birthplace. What is the position of a thana? How is the building? How people live? So what happens is we must shift this focus of policing from fear to connectedness to service. Now what happens in Mufassil areas or in rural areas or especially where the feudal sentiments were very strong, that a police station of 1+4 or 1+7 used to control a huge area, and the whole focus of controlling that area was ki the police aa jayegi.
Haan, ji,
that
bilkul.
Was unfair.
Bilkul.
I think that is a very wrong kind of notion in this modern world and in a democratic, independent country to operate on. We are a service, like Indian administrative service, Indian police service and all other services. We are here to serve the people and we are here to minimize their grievances, their problems, their unhappiness, their sense of injustice. And we should and we have to ensure that they have faith in you. For example, if you speak of Scotland Yard or London police, why people have faith in them?
Yeah.
Because when they go, they find them as a friend.
Exactly, sir. Exactly.
So we are here also as friends.
Yeah. Definitely.
But unfortunately, what happens that our training avenues are smaller. And as far as the behavioral part is concerned, we need to pay more attention to the behavioral part.
That I think you guys are the best here in Maharashtra. Maharashtra police is the best. I think you should develop a plan or idea in which you can go to other states and teach other police departments some basic ethics. Do you think that it would help dealing?
I think the empathy is a must in public dealing. Anybody who is coming to us is our customer. As Gandhiji has said, and there is a very famous saying that the person who is coming to us is the person due to whom we exist. If there wouldn't have been any complaints, there was no need to have a police.
Correct.
And our salary comes from their taxes. So we must understand this thing. We are not here to rule, but we are here to serve people. One. Secondly, even though we keep on getting the same kind of thing every day in and day out, still, this is the first experience for the person who is coming to us. So we must put ourselves in their shoes and imagine what kind of attention or what kind of treatment I would have expected if I would have gone to the police station. Population itself is increasing, their interaction is increasing, a lot of nature of crime is also increasing, but we must also understand this thing that the person who is coming to us is coming for hope, is coming for succor, he is coming with a feeling that they are there to help us.
Okay.
And that feeling must never be must never end in a negation. Otherwise, he will go back to the society and tell 100 other people, no, wahan ja ke kuch nahi hota, they are not good people and all that. In fact, I would recall an interaction with a poet. He came from Delhi, and there was a mushaira going on in there's a hall here, Birla Matoshri.
Okay.
So I had some other functions to attend. I went there as a listener. But since people knew me, they made me sit in the front row. So he started passing comment like this, कि आप तो हमेशा late आते हैं, तो जब parliament पे attack हुआ तो आप क्यों जल्दी आ गए, क्यों time से आ गए? I felt very bad. I felt extremely bad, and I replied to him, brother, you have come from Delhi to this place, you will be carrying a big sum of money through your recitation. What is the guarantee that you will reach safe there? On what guarantee, on what kind of presumption you have come here? The presumption is that you are safe, you are secure, whatever you have earned, you will be able to take it back to your home safely. So why were you passing this kind of comment? I felt bad, I felt really disgusted. There are so many people say this kind of thing. which is actually...
I can imagine the kind of hurt which you must have felt, that I can very well imagine. Ladies and gentlemen, one of the coolest cop, Mr. Kaiser Khalid, who you don't find any arrogance, you don't find any attitude. There's a lot of humbleness. He has a power to see things beyond obvious. He's one of the greatest cops I have interviewed so far. A great fan of Lal Bahadur Shastri. We know this, we'll just cross-check with him. Especially he liked the way he sought his education, carrying his bag on his head between the confluence of the Ganga, Yamuna and Saraswati. Could you tell us something about Lal Bahadur Shastri? How he became your role model? Of course, he is one of them. So,
Shastriji was a great person. Who could have imagined a person coming from such a background would rise to become the Prime Minister of India? And if you read his biography, it's all about hard work, conviction and faith in the system. Which, when I go back to slums or people who are not so well off economically, I tell them, look at him. Your India is still a much better India because it has advanced. So many things have come. Resources, hospitals, education, roads, communication. When Shastriji was a child, what kind of India he had had? India under the British regime, and there was hardly any development. Then he did not lose faith. Then he did his best. Then he had this conviction and the hard work that he has put in.
Are you in touch with all of your friends, or it's difficult for you?
Some of them. Unfortunately, what happens, in fact, this is sad to say, that the kind of seriousness that we should have had for life when we were in high school was not there in many people. And their dreams were too small, very small dreams. Probably somebody wanted to become a teacher, or somebody wanted to become some kind of small things. I have nothing against doing any job. I respect all of them. But I would say that one should dream beyond what is obvious, what you see, what you look at.
Exactly.
So if my father was a teacher, if at all I should have dreamt of becoming a professor, not a teacher.
Exactly.
Or I should have dreamt something which they could not dream or they could not reach to. So most of my colleagues in high school have not done well, and they have gone back to the profession of farming or small trading here and there.
But do they at times call you up?
Yeah. And they keep me grounded, na? Because
yes,
here people
yes.
will say,
Sahab. I think those are the people who are not to be forgotten also. Because if they want to connect with you, so there is a kind of, I don't know, a feeling which only you can understand.
Oh, they will call, kaisa kaisa hai tu?
Oh,
I mean, when
wow.
You, when yes, they ask yes, you this
yes.
way,
this, is what
this
I wanted
language,
to know. Yes.
But we call in Marathi as Ekari language,
Ekari.
The singular language.
Mm.
So what happens that then you realize, ki, yes, there are people who are equal. And with whom this job does not matter. And
this is what I wanted to hear. Ek kaisar kaisa hai tu? You know, that was the classiest. You know?
Because I respect these people and I meet. And in village, some time ago when I used to go, I used to make it a point to go and reach out to my relatives who
yes.
cannot be so well off.
Yes.
I used to go. They expect you to say salam first.
Yes.
And I think as younger in age, it is my duty. To say salam to them and to vacate chair for them when they come.
Yeah, those are the
and
ethics.
And people notice these things.
Ah.
So that they should not get this impression that simply because you have got a job, you have become something great. Because
I think these are what you're talking about. These are, you know, the small and nitty gritty things which make a person big and small. I'm sure the class fellow of Jawaharlal Nehru, when he was must have been studying, his benchmate would have said, he has become the Prime Minister and I have not. So there are these small things, as very categorically defined by Kaiser Saab, respect or logon ko ahmiyat dena, unki baaton ko sunna, all these things, you know, it's all in a huge big package. Kaiser Saab, always a pleasure talking to you, though it was my first interview, but with you. But I haven't seen such a dynamic man.
Thank you, sir.
And with dynamism, you have humanity, you have your eyes, which I see, they are always in quest. And thanks a lot for
Pleasure.
Talking to us.
Pleasure.
Thank you so much. That was Kaiser Khalid. Keep watching.
Hey, if you enjoyed the video, hit the like button. And if you wish to see more of our content, hit that subscribe button. Keep watching the Reba Ayaz Show.